Hello guys, and welcome to my second airplane editing tutorial. And yeah, obviously my first video with my own voice. Today's tutorial is going to be about Lightroom and Photoshop, the two tools I use to edit my photos. I made another tutorial because I got so many DMs requesting a new one, since my first video is already about 9 months old. I hope that all of you can learn some new techniques and implement part of my workflow into yours. For today's video, I've selected this shot. I took this shot about 3 weeks ago at Zurich Airport. As you can see, we don't have that much of an interesting background at all, but we do have some already nice clouds that we're going to enhance. So let's get started. At first, you always want to go down to the lens corrections and tick both of these boxes. The first one will remove all chromatic aberrations, which are those annoying pink and green lines you sometimes get. The second box will remove vignetting and lens distortions. After that, I always proceed to the details. I usually sharpen to amount of 50 and noise reduction 50 and color noise reduction 50 as well. These terms work best for me, but you might have to use some other amounts depending on your ISO and your camera. After we have done those little things, we want to proceed to the more interesting and exciting parts. First of all, I'm going to crop the image to what I want it to look like in the end. For this photo, I chose a 4x5 crop. Just crop your image until you like it best. Try different ratios and angles, and if there is something cut off, it doesn't really matter that much. For example, I cut off the left wing a bit. The next thing I always do is to play around with the exposure, highlights, shadows, whites and blacks a bit. And of course, the contrast. This might take a while. Again, just play around a bit until you like it best. I usually add about 20 contrasts, lower the highlights a bit, increase shadows and whites a little. Then I usually lower the vibrance of the image a bit. I just like it a bit more. You don't have to do this step, but I always do it. Next step, we want to add some brush strokes to edit certain areas of the photo. The first brush I always add is some texture. I apply this to the windows, livery and more. I personally think it looks pretty good. Little disclaimer, I lowered the highlights -8 here, that's a mistake of mine, so just don't mind. The next thing I always do is to brighten up the engines in certain parts of the aircraft, like the landing gears. And because the Qatar Airways livery is in a purple magenta color, we are going to enhance these two colors a bit. We're now done with editing the aircraft itself. We're now going to save the photo as a TIFF file. This is really important. TIFF doesn't compress the image in any way, unlike JPEG or PNG. We now want to reset all brush strokes and edit the background of the image. I'm later going to combine both edits using Photoshop. For the background edit, I always like to use two gradients, one from the top and one from the bottom. Right now, I'm just adjusting them until I like the way the photo looks. And don't mind the aircraft now. The aircraft looks badly over-edited, but don't worry. In general, I always make the background a bit darker than the aircraft itself, just to kind of separate the aircraft from the background a bit more. If you're happy with how your background looks, export the file again as a TIFF. And then we're gonna go and proceed to Photoshop. and I took both edits into Photoshop, the background layered on top of the foreground. You're now gonna see why I did this and how we're gonna get rid of the over edit on the aircraft. We're now gonna use the eraser tool in Photoshop to erase the whole aircraft on the top layer. Now we want to use this tool to select everything we want to delete afterwards. Now selecting everything, this might take a while depending on how trained you're already. This took me like 5 minutes. Flames alert the trees, spread to fallen leaves. Now they're back upon me. Wait if I'm on fire. How am I so deep in love? Once you've done selecting everything, just click on delete. Now we have successfully combined both edits. I'm still not 100% happy with how the edit turned out, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna use the camera raw filter in Photoshop to edit the layers themselves. In my case, I want to edit the colors of the Qatar Airways logo a bit more. So for this, we're just gonna crop out the Qatar Airways logo and create a new layer with it. Now, I want to use the quick selection tool to select everything that's with the Qatar Airways logo and create a new layer with it so we can edit this. Wait if I'm on fire. How am I so deep in love when I dream of dying? I never feel so loved. Wait if I'm on fire. How am I so deep in love? We're now going to use the camera raw filter to edit the Qatar Airways logo. What I did, I just added some saturation and did some stuff in the exposure. Not that much, but I think it really looks a lot better already. I'm gonna do some minor changes to the photo now, just to make the photo look a bit better. Nothing huge, but yeah. Wait if I'm on fire. How am I so deep in love when I dream of dying? I never feel so. Wait if I'm on fire. How am I so deep? I now added my watermark. So usually I put the opacity to 20 to about 40% depending on the background. Since we have quite a bright background here, I chose about 40%. So here's a quick before and after on the edit. Honestly, I'm pretty happy with the outcome. I've already posted a very similar photo on my Instagram a couple of days ago. So, I hope you liked this video. If you did, I'd be happy if you leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos in future. And don't hesitate to ask me for more advice via my Instagram. Also, I'd be pleased if you sent me your edits after you've watched this video. Have a good one.